Amateur Days. It's not the Niles special. A Seraphine going to be locked in here for EG, which is always nice to see. And that is going to confirm Gragas to the top side of the map. And Ignar is going to take the Seraphine this time.
And Seraphine right now is really powerful because of the extra range. That combined with Jhin has some very, very devastating poke. Now level 6, Ryze level 6. Both want to be able to roam using their ultimates. And bottom side might be the site of that roam.
Yep, actually going to go straight there. Ablaze Olive lines it up, and that's first blood for Stixxay. Very well executed by Golden Guardians. Yep. I actually thought that we were going to see some action on the top side of the map, because again, Jace's big tests come when other people enter your lane, not the enemy top laner generally. But it was the bottom side where the action happened, since Garen at least rotates down a little late, but enough to get the dragon, which is nice here for EG. They'll be the first ones to claim Drake in this particular game.
Go unseen, unless Iconic heads straight there with a bowling ball.
Yeah, Iconic's busy actually leashing the blue for Ablaze Olive, unfortunately, so it will be Spence Garen that collects it. Now Iconic sees what's up. Gonna look to try and get the E down for me. We haven't seen Ablaze Olive able to use that ulti again, is the other thing as well. After that first one, you know, being contained, being pressured by Jazuke and Sven is nice, says, yep, teleport's coming in everywhere. That's Ryze. Ooh, Prince Garen pops out as well. Now Niall's going to have to play Ring Around the Rosie in the alcove. Does have his flash, going to go in onto Jazuke, knock him back, but there's no getting out of that one. As Ablaze Olive wants in, looks for the kill on Jazuke, but the wild cards are going to miss. He flashes in, and that's a tragedy for the Twisted Fate as Impact grabs the double kill.
They got the Rift Herald so early, they had multiple looks to go for, and they complete the ideal play. First turret bonus for them, hard shove on top side to ram it right back through. It will be a counter dragon for Golden Guardians, but the problem with that is that because you give up so much gold, because you're so far behind in gold, to actually fight the next dragon.
Oh, Impact, that was so filthy. If there were no minions there, that would have been even sweeter. In fact, might still be good enough. Jazuke zooming in, ready with the phase burst. No flash from last time. Impact flashes in to secure it, and Jazuke gets gifted a kill on a silver platter. The thing that cascaded to this point of the game. Oh, he's there again. Niles.
Hello!
In a 1v4, ooh, very fancy, but I don't think it's going to get you out of there. Going to knock Impact back, but Ignar's the one to claim the kill here, as the rest of Golden Guardians are going to maybe try for a counter kill. Definitely isn't here, but there's no angle for the fight there for Golden Guardians as Niles just goes down.
Yeah, you got to think there's just...
Still going, okay, well, by the way. Another route from this Ryze is causing a lot of issues. Encore snipes Iconic over the side, and Ignar gets a well-deserved kill number 2.
Yeah,
but now the TP in from EG. That's Impact right into the middle of everybody, and that might not be recommended. Shutdown there for Stixxay. Ignar letting it rip, does get the Encore onto Nubia, but the route does not land, and Golden Guardians pick one up.
Yeah, that was deep. I was like, okay, you know what? I'm defaulting to trust on Impact. That is a deep teleport under the turret. It turns out, yeah, Golden Guardians are well equipped to handle that one. They lock him right back down. EG give one back.
Just leaving Shelly in the mid lane.
Set it and forget it. I actually like that because they're going to contest around this dragon. Keep GG here. Shelly will take care of a lot of damage on that mid turret while they work with Golden.
Now it's a little too low, though. Gets rooted again. And definitely just the one to clean it up. And now Impact is here on the front side. He gets himself stumped. But Jazuke on that flank is going to mean EG should have this Drake unless the steal comes in. But it does not. It definitely that secures it for Evil Geniuses. They're up in kills and dragons and gold. It's just all going well for the Evil Geniuses. They will suspect thanks to Joseph. And that blue trinket will confirm it. That Baron's fallen pretty quick, though. Ignar also, again, continuing to zone people out. In fact, Golden Guardians can't get in. They're going to lose to Baron. That Kai'Sa W looked very close, but Smite is there for Spence Garen. And here comes Jazuke, going to get the boys in with the ulti out of Ryze. And it's carnage as Spence Garen's going to take out Niles. Ankar over the top there for Ignar as Iconic goes golden, but there's just abilities being thrown every possible way as definitely is going to find the sniper. No Ablaze Olive. 2-for-1 already, going to make it 3-4 as Stixxay gets rooted by Ignar's very nice skill shot accuracy, although Stixxay is going to try and turn it back around. Definitely flashes in there to secure the next one as it's 3 dropped already for Golden Guardians.
Oh yeah, it was a little touch and go there for a second. Nice excitement.
Still having 50 seconds left for EG as they're going to knock down the tier 2 in mid. No way to defend that one. Spence Garen's going to go in. Gale forces forward. Impact's also in there. Great ulti straight into the Seraphine route, and definitely just picking people off. Easy as you please with the Jhin.
All right, they keep it going. Charm him
in. Stixxay, follow-up route, no good. EG moving back in. It's just going to be absolute massacre here in the mid lane as Niles finally gets himself a trade, but now he's got to hightail it out of there.
To have my friend. We had a few little audio issues right there, cleaned up really quickly. Right back here, though, for the action and the exciting end to our best of three series here, as EG looking like with almost a 10K gold lead, they'll be able to reset after this one.
As EG do take down the top inhibitor tower, they're going to look to take the in here pretty quickly here as well. The boys all with the rapid fire gold card, trying to find a juicy target, but can't get it just yet as the inhib does fall. Impact in there again. Jazuke insta flashes in. Seraphine ulti is going to follow through. A two-man charm there out of Ignar. Definitely, once again, is playing janitor. And Stixxay is going to try and make something happen, but Svenskeren's going to shut that down as Rakan gets sniped off by Deathly. And Impact will seal the deal as Iconic, the only one left alive, as Deathly grabs himself the triple. And it's looking to be yet another ace here as Iconic into the fountain. He goes. Deathly wants to take him down. He gets himself killed, though. Executed, in fact, as Iconic will not fall. But unfortunately, for Golden Guardians, the Nexus will not share the same fate as the Lilia, as EG will take the expected 2-0 sweep over Golden Guardians.
They even put the ward down to remember the spot Deathly died at the fountain again. That's the second time, by the way, in lock-in tournament that he has died to fountain laser. Jumping in for another one of those kills.